Good morning, Chairperson, ladies and gentlemen. I am Chinde Dorji. I am from Bhutan. Today, I'm going to present on the knowledge, attitude, and practice on an assessment that was done to assess the knowledge, attitude, and practice towards health research and its utilization among health professionals in Bhutan, which was a nationwide cross-sectional survey that was done in 2019. As you all know, that health research is an important tool for development. And globally, there's this 90-10 divide where only 10% of the global resources on health research are being spent on the 90% of the diseases that cause burden in low and middle income countries. However, many of these countries lack capacity. For example, in Bhutan, in the past, efforts have been only concentrated on public health measures, and Bhutan has achieved remarkable public health successes. However, health research had remained as a low priority until only in 1995, when the Ministry of Health established the Health Research and Epidemiology Unit. And it was only in 2009 that the country's first ethics review board was established, and the country's first and only medical journal was established only in 2015. So this study was conducted to assess the knowledge, attitude, and practice of health research on health research among all categories of health professionals in Bhutan. So this was a nationwide cross-sectional survey of licensed practitioners in 2019. The sample size was calculated for that of proportion, and we did a random sampling of proportionate percentage of four categories of health workers, which included doctors, the nurses, the traditional medicine practitioners, and technologists and technicians. So this was the data was collected using self-administered questionnaire. Knowledge was tested using 10 questions, and it was categorized into good knowledge if they scored more than 80. 60 to 70% was categorized as fair knowledge, and less than 60% was categorized as poor knowledge. And we did a weighted analysis for this purpose. In the results, only a quarter of the participants had good knowledge, and 53.5% had fair knowledge, and 22% had poor knowledge. The mean score was 6.2, with a standard deviation of 2 out of 10. There was a negative correlation with age, which meant that the younger health professionals had a better knowledge than the older ones. And as the number of, as the participants had taken up more number of projects, their knowledge was better. And again, the knowledge was better as their qualifications increased. As you can see, there were only 13.4% who had received in-service training, which means after they had joined the service. There was an overwhelming positive attitude towards health research, and the majority believed that conducting local research would contribute in generating local evidence. However, in terms of practice, only 22.7% had ever conducted research, and only 6% had published journal articles, and only 4.3% had presented in conferences. So the major challenges that were identified in conducting health research in Bhutan at this moment were lack of knowledge, mainly on statistics and research methodology, and limitation of time, as many of the clinicians are responsible for other clinical work, and lack of resources for literature search. In conclusion, the self-reported knowledge was fair, the attitude was overwhelmingly positive, and very minimal had had actual experience in conducting research. Overall, I'd like to conclude that this research gives away a point that this is the right time to invest in research capacity building in Bhutan. Thank you.